What's up, guys? I'm Taylor, and I have read 8 books in 2019 that have made a positive impact on my life. I'm going to talk about the title of each book, and I'm going to go over what impact it had on my life, and hopefully it has a positive impact on your life as well. So without further ado, let's check out the books. Book number one. Wait, before that, disclaimer. These are not in any particular order. The only order these are in is basically when I read them. And I'm not sponsored. Okay, now that that's out of the way. Book number one. This book told me how to not stress over every little thing. Like, oh my gosh, this book is all about managing stress management. You don't have to stress over everything in your life, but choose to stress over one or two important things that really, really matter to your life, that you really care about. That is what this book has taught me, and it's been very effective. I'm a professional software engineer, and I have been working my whole life to be a professional software engineer, so I take it very, very seriously. I work really hard to make the best quality software that I can, and I'm pretty critical on myself whenever I make mistakes, so that I can learn from those mistakes and create even better quality software. And when other things come up in my life, like what to wear to a fancy restaurant or other little small things like, oh my gosh, am I keeping my apartment clean enough? Those things I've learned to not really stress out as much over, because those don't really push my life forward as much as being a better software engineer. So I don't put as much stress on myself over those little things. And that is what this book has taught me to do. And I'm really, really appreciative of the lesson that I learned from this book. Okay, moving on. Book number two. Okay, I don't actually have the book because I lent it to my friend. So it is called Never Split the Difference. And it's written by an ex-FBI agent who was a hostage negotiator, and it basically talks about negotiation tactics that the FBI uses and how you can actually apply those to your everyday life. And you can apply them to anything. It has really taught me how to best apply a negotiation tactic towards big purchases, like buying a house or buying a car. And it's taught me the importance of how to say no to things that you don't actually want. Like if someone is offering you a huge amount on a car and you want to get it lower to a price that you can afford and is reasonable, then by all means, you have to say no to whatever that person is offering because they want a certain amount of money. You want to pay as little as possible for a car. And that has been very beneficial to me. It also can apply to your career choice as well. If you're applying for a job and they're offering you a salary that just doesn't cut it, then it's very important to learn to say no and to negotiate a higher salary so you can be getting paid the maximum amount and also spending the least amount of money. So increase your money. Also, it stresses the importance of actually like listening to what people have to say and understanding what their wants and their needs are, because everyone has different perspective on life, and it's very important to understand where other people are coming from. It will just make you a more likable person, and you will be able to relate to people better that way. That is also a very important lesson that this book has taught me. All right, moving on. Book number three. I can't do three. Book number three. Shoot video that doesn't suck. This kind of applies to this video, right? So this book has a lot of good techniques in how to shoot all kinds of video, from YouTube videos to interview videos to weddings, like all these different scenarios. And it's really taught me some of the techniques that big YouTubers and video makers use, why those techniques work, and how to apply them to my videos whenever I shoot. I haven't really been able to put a lot of these in practice because I don't make a lot of videos, but it is very good information, and I recommend this to anyone who wants to get into video. This is a fantastic book to really understand the techniques behind video, and there's also like very little subtle things that you don't think about, but when you read it in this book and you see it in other videos, you're like, oh yeah, like I can totally pinpoint what technique that video that I just watched is pulling out of this book. Book number four is called Like and Subscribe. So what this book has taught me is how to hit the like button and to smash the subscribe button on this channel specifically, because that would just be great. It's not an actual book. Guys, if you really like the video, drop a like, please subscribe for future content. On to the next book. Book number five, which is an actual real book. Just wanna put that out there. This is an actual real book, and it's called Read This If You Want to Take Great Photographs. Right there, can you see that? Yeah, look at that font. That font looks amazing. It's like all glossy on black. I love it. So yeah, this book has a lot of good techniques on photos, much like the How to Shoot Video That Doesn't Suck. It has a lot of techniques, and they accompany them with a lot of photos for those techniques. So you have like a visual representation of what it's talking about. So it'll go over things like how to have correct composition in your photo, and it will give you an example of a photo that has good composition. And it will talk about things like leading lines, and it will follow that up with a photo of good leading lines. And this has been really helpful to me because I've actually been putting a lot of effort into my Instagram this year, taking photos with my Sony camera, which I'm filming this on right here. This book has just been so helpful. So helpful in taking amazing photographs, and it has been really helpful. So I recommend it to anyone who wants to get into photography, who wants to learn photography quickly, because this book is an easy read. You can learn photography very quickly with this. Yeah, anyone who wants to get out and create, I definitely recommend this book. All right, book number six, Creativity Inc. All right, so this was written by the president or CEO of Pixar, I forget, but he was very big in Pixar. He kind of tells his story about how Pixar came to be. And this book sends a really good message on what a good company looks like to work for. And I think this is very important because a lot of viewers might be entering into a company for the first time, or they might not be happy with their current company for whatever reason. And this book kind of sums up what a good company looks like. And it goes over things like, does the company listen to their employees? Does the company value the employees' ideas? And is hierarchy inside the company blocking those ideas, kind of thing? And it's all about, you know, making sure that everyone has a voice within the company, because that's how the real problems are gonna get solved. Good people are gonna take the challenge to solve hard problems, and those hard problems are going to benefit the company, because the company is gonna be able to overcome new challenges, which is gonna result in the company making more money. So this book, I think, has a really good representation of what a company like that looks like, and it's also super interesting to see the history of Pixar, all the factors that went into it, and it's a very amazing story. I recommend you guys check it out. The last book, I don't have the physical copy either. I have it as an ebook. I read it as an ebook. I typically don't like ebooks. I like physical books like this that I can, you know, turn pages and flip through and feel the book. I don't know. I'm weird, but that is Ready Player One. And yes, this was a movie. And shortly after the movie, I went out and I read the book. And oh my gosh, the book is amazing. And I learned a very valuable lesson in that. And that is that video games are amazing. And I think every one of us loves video games. If you're on YouTube, you've probably played a video game in your life. And let's face it, they're incredible. They tell amazing stories, they enter you into these crazy amazing worlds, but also this book stresses how important it is that there's life outside of video games. And I know for me personally, like, I've played video games since I was 10 years old, and sometimes I get really sucked into video games and I kind of put aside real life in place of video games. I've totally done that before. And that is not a healthy approach. There is totally life outside of video games. This book, you know, stresses the importance of like there are good people out in this world. And life is all about finding those good people, the people who want to help others, the people who want to create new things, the people who encourage others to live their best life. All these factors are qualities of a good person, and it's really hard to find people like that. There's not many people out in this world who do that sort of thing. And the challenge is going out and finding those people, surrounding yourself with those people, and you will be happy. Ah, you thought that was the last book, didn't you? Well, I did too. There's one more, actually. This book, I Will Teach You to Be Rich. This book has taught me a lot of valuable things, from credit cards to how to best save my money and invest my money. And I definitely recommend this book to everyone. This book is so beneficial to anyone who likes money, and I think we all like money and want to grow our wealth so that we can be pretty much financially free. So check this book out. It's like set up as a 6-week program. So week one, it's like credit cards, and then week six, it's like how do you manage things like marriage finances kind of thing, and everything in between, from putting your money in savings accounts, into HSAs, into Roth IRAs, good stuff like that. I really recommend you check out this book. Really helps me a lot. Those are the 8 books that I've read in 2019 that have changed my life. Well, 7, because the 8th book was to like and subscribe. And please like and subscribe. I know I haven't made a lot of content, but I'm totally looking forward to creating new content in 2020. It's gonna be super exciting. Also, I have an Instagram where I've been working on photos. You can look at the description down there in the link. The link is down there in the description. There we go. That's the sentence I was looking for. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I hope 2020 is an amazing year for you.